الحمد لله الذي أضعف ما حمده جميع خلقه كما يحبه ويرضاه. سبحان الله وبحمده سبحان الله العظيم. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. اللهم اجعلنا دعاة إليك وإلى رسولك أما بعد. فقد قال الله تعالى في كتابه الكريم: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يوم ندعو كل نفس، يوم ندعو كل أناس بإمامهم، فمن أوتي كتابه بيمينه فأولئك يقرؤون كتابهم ولا يظلمون فتيلا. وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: من أحب قوما فهو منهم، وفي رواية أخرى حشر معهم. صدق الله العلي العظيم وصدق رسول الكريم ونحن على ذلك من الشاهدين ومن الشاكرين والحمد لله رب العالمين. Indeed, all praises are for Allah, and we praise Allah and we thank Allah and we glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Al-Ahad, Allah who is the one. We glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Al-Basir, the one who sees everything. Allah, we glorify him, As-Sami', the one who hears everything. We glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Al-Hadi, the one who guides the hearts of insan, the one who guides the hearts of mankind. We glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Al-Khabir, the one who is aware and well acquainted with everything. We thank Allah, we praise Allah, and we send peace and blessings on Allah's final messenger, Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. Indeed, my dear brothers, my dear sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has continued to be kind and merciful to us. Allah has continued to show His rahmah and His mercy, His compassion and His love upon us. Allah continues to look after our hearts. Allah continues to polish and to brighten and illuminate our hearts with the gift and the quality of Iman. Because without Iman, my dear brothers, my dear sisters, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, مَثَلُ الَّذِي يَذْكُرُ رَبَّهُ وَالَّذِي لَا يَذْكُرُهُ كَمَثَلِ حَيِّ وَالْمَيِّتِ. Without Iman, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gives the example. It is Iman that causes a person to remember his Rabb. It is Iman that causes a person to be conscious that Allah is looking, that Allah is listening, that Allah is well acquainted. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gives an example. He says that without Iman, it is like the example of that one who remembers his Lord and the example of that one who does not remember his Lord is the similitude of the living and the dead. So in other words, when we have Iman, alhamdulillah, we are alive. Without Iman, we are dead. Even though we are walking on the face of the earth, it is Iman that distinguishes the consciousness and the recognition and the ma'rifah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from those people who don't remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at all. So we thank Allah ta'ala for this gift. When we look on the world today, throughout the globe, throughout the world, What it takes for the believer, what it takes for the non-believer, something is running through the veins of the insan. Something is running through the vein of the haywanat, from the insan, from the animal kind. What is that thing that is very, very crucial for our living? If that is drained out, then we would realize that there is no life in the body anymore. This thing which is known as dam, this thing which is known as blood, the blood that is flowing in our veins. When we look throughout the world today, my dear brothers, my dear sisters, we will see that the very said blood that we are dependent upon for our existence on the earth, for our living, we will see it's the very said blood that is flowing in the rivers throughout the world from our brothers and our sisters. Their bloods are flowing in the rivers. Their lives are being taken away without any just cause, without any just reasons. Is there any difference with my little baby and the little baby of a non-believer? Is there a difference with the mothers of the ummah and the mothers who are not from the ummah in regards to their children and the love that they show for their children? Why is it then people are crying out? Non-Muslims are crying out to their governments, crying out to those in power, crying out to them, calling them liars in regards to what is taking place with the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That there is such a difference, there is such a big difference with this little child because this child is a Muslim and this child is not a Muslim. That the blood of one, it is okay to take, and the blood of the other, it's wrong. Non-Muslims are crying out for this injustice and this oppression that is being taken place in the world today. But the thing is, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Sadiq al-Amin, the truthful and the trustworthy, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that one who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not utter a word, Allah says, he does not utter a word except that he is inspired by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is he who had mentioned to us in regards to every single thing that is going to happen in regards to this dunya. It is he sallallahu alaihi wasallam who had mentioned to us in regards to everything that is going to happen in regards to akhirat. And as we see the times, and as we see the tribulations, and the calamities, and the trials, every single advent that he had foretold, it is being unfolded in front of our very eyes today. Right in front of our eyes. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he spoke to us about this time that we are living in. And it has to happen like that, lest his words be proven to be false. And the words of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam can never be false. Today the celebration is being taken place. And people will soon be celebrating the birthday of Isa alayhi salam. This thing which is known as Christmas. They say it is the celebration for the birth of Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. But even the Christians throughout the world, even the Jews throughout the world, many of them, they claim that this is a false claim. It is a false claim because Isa alayhi salatu wasalam was not born on the 25th of December. Even in the biblical scriptures, it is mentioned like that. And mind you, sad to say, Muslims today celebrate Christmas probably more than the other religions. Why? When Allah Ta'ala has given us Eid al-Fitr and Eid al-Adha. What is significant in the life of Isa alayhi salatu wasalam that we need to know? It's not Christmas. It is something that is going to happen. A man is going to be raised in the land. This land that is filled of oppression and tyranny. This land that is filled with turmoil. A man is going to be raised. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, لا تذهب الدنيا حتى يملك العرب رجلٌ رجلٌ من أهل بيتي. This world is not going to go away. This world is not going to come to an end until a man rules over the Arabs from amongst Ahlul Bayt, from amongst his household. He says, يُوَاطِيُ إِسْمُهُ إِسْمِي. He will have a similar name like mine. وَإِسْمُ أَبِيهِ إِسْمُ أَبِي. And the name of his father will also be similar to the name of my father also. Subhanallah. He will fill up the land with equity. He will fill up the land with justice, just as how it was filled up with tyranny and oppression before. His name, Yusammahu Muhammad. His name will be Muhammad ibn Abdullah. Muhammad, the son of Abdullah, just like the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And his laqab will be Al-Mahdi. His title will be Imam Al-Mahdi, the Imam of the rightly guided. The rightly guided. And he is going to come. Insha'Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The words of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He says he will be from my daughter Fatima. Auladu Fatima. From the descendants of Fatima. From the son of Hassan radiallahu ta'ala an. يَمْلِكُ سَبْعَ سِنِينَ. He will rule and he will govern this world, the land of the Arabs, throughout the world for 7 years. 7 years. While he will be there, Masih al-Dajjal will also be there. The Antichrist will also be there. The people from Khorasan, Uzbekistan, Turkmenistan, Kyrgyzstan, Afghanistan, all these people will join his army. All these people will join his flock to bring about this justice in the land. It will happen that when Dajjal will be there, because he will be so powerful with his mighty force, subhanallah, all the miracles he will bring forth, this man known as Al-Mahdi, he won't be able to handle Dajjal. He can't handle Dajjal. So what will happen? And the white minarets of Dimashq in Damascus in Syria, he will be performing the Fajr Salah with the Muqtadis, with those who believe in Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. While he is performing the Fajr Salah, as soon as the salam is given, Isa alayhi salatu wassalam, with his palms on the wings of two angels, he will be descending and coming down from the heavens, joining Imam Mahdi. His role, understand it well, the role of Isa alayhi salatu wassalam coming on the face of the earth is to handle and to deal with the Dajjal. When he comes, he will take chase behind the Dajjal immediately. He will set peace and order in the land. And subhanallah, he will deal with Dajjal. It will only be Isa alayhi salatu wassalam. He will break the cross that these people have him hanging on. He will break the cross. He will kill the swine. And he will remove and abolish the jizya or the tax. This is the role of Isa alayhi salatu wassalam. So much so that he will establish law on the land. That Allah for himself says in the Quran about the Yahud, about the Jews, about the Nasara, about the Christians. وَإِن مِّنْ أَهْلِ الْكِتَابِ إِلَّا لَيُؤْمِنَنَّ بِهِ قَبْلَ مَوْتِهِ. That there is none from amongst the people of the book, the Jews and the Christians, except that they must believe in Isa alayhi salam before his death. What is the ayat saying? Before his death. There is none that must believe in him before his death. To some, he have already died. For the Muslims, Isa alayhi salam did not die. And this is why, before his death, every single Jew, every single Christian will believe in Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. Allah says, "Wa yawm al-qiyamah yakunu alayhim shahida." And all those who made false claim against him, all those who celebrated his birthday, all those who said Isa ibn Allah, Isa is the son of Allah, all those who curse his mother, Buhtan and Azima, they curse his mother. All those people, Allah is saying, on the day of Qiyamah, Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, he is going to be a witness, not for them, but against them. Against them. Where do the ummatis of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam fall in all of this? Where do we fall in regards to Isa alayhi salatu wasalam? It must be understood what his role is as a prophet of Allah. That he is not God. Some people say Isa ibn Allah. Isa is the son of God. Some say Isa, who Allah? Isa alayhi salam, he is Allah. Some say Uzayr ibn Allah. Some say Uzayr is the son of Allah. Some say Al-Malaikatu Banatullah. The angels are the daughters of Allah. And everybody is saying something. Allah tells us the truth. So Isa alayhi salatu wasalam is coming. But what he's coming for? To deal with Masihud Dajjal. To deal with the Antichrist. Even after he kills the Dajjal. Even after that, there will be more trials and tribulation on the land. So much trial that there will be two tribes. Two tribes that will arise in the land. Their names will be Ya'juj and Ma'juj. We know them in English as Gog and Magog. There will be too much for Isa alayhi salam to handle and his followers. Too much. So much that they will pass by a river, and some others who will be coming after, they will say, once upon a time there used to be water in this river. They will drink out the water. This is the extent of how much. Quran says, Yansiluna alay. They will come and they will ride upon each other's back. Just like how we see ants crawling on top of each other. This is how much they will be. There will be too much for Isa alayhi salatu wasalam to handle. So what Allah Ta'ala will do? Allah will send his help. How? Today, there is something that is taking place in regards to a small thing as a mosquito. There's a disease going around. If you get bite by this mosquito, they call it Zika. You could die. You could die. How small or how big is this thing? How big is this insect? Wow. Allah is going to send a little insect. A little insect is going to bite them on their necks. And what is going to happen? It's going to take them out. Don't underestimate the power of these small things. This is how Allah is going to wipe them out from the face of the earth. By sending this small insect. And even after that, even after they are wiped out from the face of the earth, after they have become killed by these little insects, they will be lying about the place, dead corpse, with this stench. This bad smell. Who is going to remove them? Who is going to bury them? Subhanallah. So much. Isa alayhi salam will make dua to Allah again. Make dua to Allah for what? For help again. Allah Ta'ala will send the rains. The rains that we are experiencing right now. But not in this small amount. Rains upon rains upon rains will come and wash the earth. And wash them away from the earth. The land will become pure again. The land will be filled with justice and equity. Subhanallah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Walladhi nafsi biyadihi, I swear by that one in whose hands lies my soul, la yu'shikunna ayyunazzala fikum ibn Maryam, that it is a certainty that the son of Maryam will bring down to you justice and administration. Hakaman adlan, what we call law and order. Isa alayhi salam will set a peace on the face of the earth. Law and order. No more injustice, no more tyranny. So be very, very careful, my dear brothers, my dear sisters, in regards to Isa alayhi salatu wassalam, what we say about him, what we celebrate in regards to him, lest Isa alayhi salatu wassalam will stand on the day of Qiyamah. And what will happen? He will testify against you and he will testify against me. Allah Ta'ala says in the Quran, يَوْمَ نَدَعُوا كُلُّ أُنَاسٍ بِإِمَامِهِمْ. On that day, every single person, they will be called together with their imam. Stand, who is your imam? Do you know who your imam is? Some people don't have any imams. Some people don't recognize imams. Some people, they don't believe in imams. Allah is saying in the Quran, Allah has used the word, يَوْمَ نَدْعُوا كُلُّ أُنَاسٍ بِإِمَامِهِمْ. On the day of judgment, Allah is going to call all of mankind behind their imam. If you don't know who your imam is, get to find out who is your imam. Which country he belongs to, which jamaat he belongs to. Know who is your imam, who is your leader. Because on the day of Qiyamah, if you have nobody to run behind, well then we don't know what will happen. When we go behind our imams, Allah says, فَمَنْ أُوْتِيَ كِتَابَهُ بِيَمِينِهِ. Standing behind your imam now, your books are going to be given to you. The book of deeds, your records. Whoever is given it in his right hand, فَأُولَٰئِكَ يَقْرَؤُونَ كِتَابَهُمْ. They will be able to read their books now. You know why? Because they are given it in their right hand. On the contrary, if a person is given his book in his left hand, immediately it strikes him. I don't want to see this. I don't want to see this. Sometimes when you get your results in school, teachers use black pen and they use red pen. When you see it full of red, you don't even want to look at the marks because you don't know what red stands for. Not PNM, we talk about marks. So when you see red, you close that book one time, you don't want to read it. So from the time a person gets his book in his left hand, ha umukra'u kitabiya, he's already bawling, he's already crying. Inni dhanantu anni mulakin hisabiya. Halaka anni sultaniya. All my power, all my wealth, everything has been destroyed. Khudhuhu fagullu. Take him, tie him up, throw him into the fire. Thumma al-jahima sallu. Throw him into the fire. But that one who has been given his book in his right hand, the Quran is saying, no, he opens his book, he is reading his book. وَلَا يُظْلَمُونَ فَتِيلًا. No injustice whatsoever for him. Everything that was said to him, he listened. Everything that he was taught about the Quran, the teachings of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, this deen of al-Islam, he listened. He put it into practice. Allah is saying, no justice for you, no injustice for you. Take your reward now. Take your reward now. On the contrary, وَمَنْ كَانَ فِي هَذِهِ أَعْمَى. In regards to that one, in regards to that one who lived in this world, who lived in this world and he was blind. He was blind. How? How he became blind? Subhanallah. He followed his nafs. He didn't listen. You know what they say? You show a person a path, he will see it, he will see it, he will see it. But I ain't ready for that as yet. I ain't ready for that. وَمَنْ كَانَ فِي هَذِهِ أَعْمَى. Whoever lived in this world and he lived in such a state that he was blinded by the gurur. وَمَا الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا إِلَّا مَتَاءُ الْغُرُورِ. What is the life of this world except chattels and things of amusement, things of deception? He was deceived by what he saw here. Allah says, فَهُوَ فِي الْآخِرَةِ أَعْمَى وَأَضَلَّ سَبِيلًا. Then in the akhirat, he will also be raised up blind. Worse than blind, subhanAllah, more astray from the path. In this world, he went astray from the rightly guided path. In the other world, he will be going astray from the path that leads to Jannah. So then where he will be heading? Where will he be heading? Straight towards the fire of Jahannam. This is the words of Allah Ta'ala. These are the words of the Quran. So whatever is happening in front of our eyes, these are prophecies of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Make dua for Imam Mahdi to come, because he will set peace, he will set justice, he will set order on the face of the earth. And if he comes and we are here, make dua that Allah put it in our hearts that we join his army also, because that is where the rightly guided ones will be, behind this Imam al-Mahdi. Make dua also that the coming of Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, his coming with haq, his coming with truth. Allah tells us in the Quran, وَقُلْ جَاءَ الْحَقِّ وَزَّهَقَ الْبَاطِلِ إِنَّ الْبَاطِلَ كَانَ زَهُكَ. When Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam entered the land of Makkah, on the conquest of Makkah, this ayat came down to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, pointing the idols in the Kaaba, reciting this very said ayat, and say, truth has come, falsehood has vanished. Falsehood is ever bound to vanish. Truth has come. Today the truth has come. Isa alayhi salam was not born on the 25th of December. The true message behind the coming of Isa alayhi salatu wasalam is to set law and order, to take out the Dajjal. Allah Ta'ala is sending him back. If we as Muslims don't believe in that, we go out of the pale of Islam. We go out of the pale of Islam. This is how simple it is. May Allah Ta'ala help us and put this quality in our hearts, this quality which is known as Iman, so that if Allah permits us and we live for that time, we will be able to be under the army and the band of Isa alayhi salatu wasalam with this very said quality which is known as Iman. This is the haq. This is the truth of Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. فَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. Don't die except in a state of submission. With this iman in our hearts, don't let death come to us. Don't let death come to us. And we did not believe in this, my dear brothers, my dear sisters. The world as we see it, the events that are occurring again and again, you and I, subhanallah, we are here as witnesses as to what is taking place of the oppression and the tyranny, of what is taking place of the falsehood and the battle that is happening in the world today. We are here to make a difference. And we can make a difference if we stand up for truth, if we stand up for justice, if we do what is right, if we say what is right, if we encourage each other towards what is right, and don't take the path that brings about deviation. Don't take the path that Allah and His Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, if we let go of this path, then of course we will fall into misguidance. If we let go of the Quran, we let go of the Sunnah, definitely we will go astray. So when we find ourselves going astray, then we know exactly the reason why. It is because we have let go of the Quran and the teachings of our Prophet Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, "Man ahabba qawman fahuwa minhum." And in another narration, "Man ahabba qawman hushira ma'ahum." That one who loves a nation, he loves a certain sect of people, then he will be from amongst them. If you love the ummatis of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the sahabas, the anbiyas of the past, the salaf as-salih, our righteous predecessors, the tabi'in, the tabi' tabi'in, those who came after and those who came after them, and all the righteous ones that connect to the teachings of Allah and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If you love their work and you love their teachings and you love them, Allah is saying to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فَهُوَ مِنْهُمْ, then you will be with them on the day of Qiyamah. And in the other narration, حُشِّرَ مَعَهُمْ, you will be raised together with them. You will be resurrected together with them. All of us will be resurrected with them on the day of Qiyamah. On the contrary, if we love those who are on dhalala, those who are on misguidance, those who choose to follow misguidance, even though they are seeing the truth, even though they know what the truth is, and we join them because we like how it feels, we like the celebration, we like the bacchanal, we like the fitna, we feel like we fit in society because we live among so many different people and we don't know where to draw the line in regards to our deen, then on the day of Qiyamah, my brothers, my sisters, all I can say sadly is that I'm very, very sorry. Very sorry. May Allah Ta'ala guide our hearts so that we will not be from amongst those. At the same time, we respect everybody's views. We respect everybody's way of life. And at the same time too, we also hope that people will respect us as well. But if we don't have honor, and if we don't have love for what we have been given by Allah and His Rasul, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then nobody else would love it. We have to love it the most. So may Allah Ta'ala guide our hearts. May He protect our hearts. May Allah show us truth as truth. May Allah continue to show us falsehood as falsehood. May Allah guide our hearts to what is the truth. Wal akhir da'wana, and alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.